Hey guys, Vikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around NanoPyOS 2. We'll see how to run Java applications on top of it. And for this, I am going to use Debian operating system on top of NanoPyOS 2. So if you have not installed Debian onto the EMMC of your NanoPyOS 2, you can do so. Or if you are wondering how to do it, you can simply check my earlier tutorial on this, for which I have given the link down below in the description. So make sure to check that out. And one more thing, in this tutorial we are simply going to install JDK onto the NanoPyOS 2 and we'll run a simple Hello World application on top of it. And in upcoming videos we'll try to access the GPIOs of NanoPyOS 2 by using Java. So stay tuned for that. So being said that, let's get started guys. So guys, to continue with this, let's first have a SSH connection to our NanoPyOS 2, and for that I am going to use PuTTY over here. And on the terminal, let's first check if we have Java already installed to the NanoPyOS 2. And for the time being, I am using Debian OS on NanoPyOS 2 as I said earlier. And over here, as you can see, it is returning that command not found. That means Java is not installed on the Debian OS that we are using on top of NanoPyOS 2. And for that reason, we just need to install it manually. And before that, we just need to update the OS. And to do that, I just need to type in the command sudo apt-get update. And it might take some time depending upon your internet speed. And while this completes, let's create a simple Java application using Eclipse. And we'll create some executable jar file that you can transfer to NanoPyOS 2 and we can run it there. And to do that, open up Eclipse or whatever IDE that you are using, but over here I am going to use Eclipse only. So open up, create a new Java project and just type in a name, let's say NanoPy demo. And the most important thing is you need to select the execution environment that is similar to your NanoPy or whatever operating system you are using on top of NanoPyOS 2. And as I am going to install Java version 7, that again I am using OpenJDK 7 because OpenJDK 8 is not available for ARM architecture. So just select Java SE 1.7 over here, and if you have 1.8 installed, you can certainly go ahead with 1.8. Now over here, just create a simple class file. Let's see, main class, include the void main. I'll have a simple println statement. Now compile the file once. Okay, we'll check it out later. Let's see if update has completed. Yeah, the update has finished. Now let's try to install OpenJDK. JDK 7, and I am going to install JDK. So I just need to download 60 MB of archives. Type Y, press enter, and it will again download the OpenJDK and it will install to our NanoPy. So let's take it to background till it get completed, and we'll check our Java application. And over here it has compiled once, so let's create the executable jar file out of it. So to do that, click on export, click on runnable jar file, select the launch configuration over here, that is the class main class name and the project name. Over here select a destination where you want to extract the jar file. I'll just select desktop. Type in a name for it. I'll just type in test.jar. Now over here you can use three types of library handling. That is, you can extract the required libraries into the jar itself, you can package the libraries into the generated jar, or you can generate the jar files or the library jar files separately into a subfolder along with the generated jar file. So I'll go ahead with third one because each time when I just transfer the generator application to my NanoPi S2, it will not be required to transfer all those files again and again. I'll just compile my project, I'll transfer the library files once, and it will do the job as long as I am not changing the required libraries. So just click on finish, and after that you will see something like test.jar and test_leaf or whatever file name you have given. Now let's check if it has finished the installation. It is yet to finish, and we are ready with our jar file. We can run it there. Now, after it finishes, let's once again check if we can type in Java, and you can see it is pointing out usage of Java command. Now we can test out the version of Java that is installed by typing in the command Java version, and it is 1.7.0.1. So let's clear it out. Now open up WinSCV or any other application that you are using to transfer the files out of our PC to the NanoPi S2, and I am using WinSCP over here, but you can use any application that you are using to transfer your files over SSH, and just select the test_leaf folder as well as test.jar file and hit upload, and it will upload the required files or the jar files to the desktop. And over here also you can select the folder you want to upload into, that you can check out yourself. Click on OK. Now on the terminal, let's navigate to desktop and type in ls. You will see something like test.jar and test_leaf. Now to run the test.jar file, you can simply use the command sudo java then fn jar then the name of the file, that is test.jar. And you can see over here it is printing out hello world as we did in our application. All the processes and all turned out successfully, and we are able to run our jar file or Java application on NanoPi S2, that is on top of Debian operating system. So that's all of this, guys. I hope you have enjoyed it, and if so, hit the thumbs up button, and if you have not subscribed yet, you can definitely subscribe to my channel for latest videos like this. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.